Ascent Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents The Seven Crucibles, an Inspirational Game Plan for Overcoming Adversity in Your Life by Alec Ingold. Narrated by Brian Wiggins. Limit of Liability and Disclaimer of Warranty. While the publisher and author have used their best efforts in preparing this book, they make no representations or warranties with respect to the accuracy or completeness of the contents of this book, and specifically disclaim any implied warranties of merchantability or fitness for a particular purpose. No warranty may be created or extended by sales representatives or written sales materials. The advice and strategies contained herein may not be suitable for your situation. You should consult with a professional where appropriate. Neither the publisher nor author shall be liable for any loss of profit or any other commercial damages, including but not limited to special, incidental, consequential, or other damages. Preface. If you want to dare to be great, this book is for you. You're just like me. If you've accepted a challenge in your life and made it a priority, you're on a journey full of ups and downs, wins and losses, peaks, valleys, and plateaus. You are chasing dreams that seem impossible to so many and inevitable to just a few friends and family. You want to be the 1% of the 1%, but you may not fully understand what it takes to get there. I want to help you understand what it takes. I've been blessed beyond my wildest expectations in my journey to the National Football League. That journey was not easy, and as you'll discover, it continues to challenge me on so many levels to this day. The Seven Crucibles will take you inside how I combined my mental, physical, and most important, spiritual gifts to help me achieve my dream. Whatever your dream is, I want you to live it too. That's why I'm going to give you the answers to the tests of adversity I've faced along the way, especially when times seem the toughest. I hope you'll use what I'm going to tell you to chase those dreams, something every one of us needs to do. But the best part of the Seven Crucibles is it doesn't stop there. I want you to learn why adversity is essential to success. Chasing dreams without adversity attached diminishes those dreams because it means you're capable of chasing something even bigger. Think of it this way. Chasing dreams without adversity is like winning a video game on the easiest setting. Dream big! Turn that difficulty meter up as high as it goes. Push yourself to your absolute limit. Fall, get back up, and keep grinding. I also want you to understand what happens on the other side of that dream. Have you ever asked yourself that question? Your life doesn't stop just because you accomplished what you want to. Life is a constant blur of motion, time, people, and circumstances, and all of them can change in a matter of moments, like when you tear an anterior cruciate ligament and you're faced with the possibility that you may never play another game in the NFL again. How do you handle something like that? What do you do next? When you chase your dreams and achieve them, of course you take some time to enjoy that your hard work paid off. But soon, you go through a necessary reality check. In your dreams, you only focus on the good, the light, the white. Nobody tells you that your dreams may come with nightmares, the failures, the fears, the dark. You have to respond to this realization with uncomfortable honesty. The longer you deny the dark, the harder it becomes to overcome that other side. That's part of the test of adversity that the crucibles in your life bring you. Ironically, it's also the part of life that nobody wants to face. Nobody can choose how you respond or how quickly. This is an internal decision that I want to help you with. Understand that unless you face adversity, you'll never get to the other side of it and find all the gifts and rewards that were meant for you. People often think they must confront the darkness on their own. That's absolutely not true. It's a process that nobody should do alone. Nor should you want to, especially if you have people and tools in your corner to help you. That's why I wrote The Seven Crucibles. You will have few problems in the light, but it's the darkness that you must overcome to lead a happy and full life. How you approach adversity in your life is a choice. I've been there, and that's why I know I can help you. I want you to understand that adversity is inevitable, especially if you've set the bar high for your life. I want you to challenge yourself, and as odd as it may seem, I want you to fail from time to time. That's because you'll learn resiliency from your failures. Failure will teach you how to adjust, and while it may not seem like it, put you one step closer to succeeding in whatever you decide you want to do with your life. The Seven Crucibles is a journey for you, just like it has been for me to write it. But you aren't traveling toward a physical destination. As you will learn, I want you to think that you're traveling inward. We're going to go through my toughest moments in life together, and in that way, I'll help you figure out the best ways to deal with your own pain and defeats. I want you to want to own the darkness of your past. It's time to be honest with yourself and learn from all of those successes and failures. If you really want to see how great you can be, it's time to start this book and commit to facing your fears so that you will never again be afraid of failing. It's time to stop the self-sabotage and commit not only to yourself, but to the people who count on you to be the best version of you. Many books are written about how to succeed, but few talk about incorporating failures and adversity as part of that process. As you'll discover, The Seven Crucibles is more than just about the setbacks I've encountered. It's also about the lessons I've learned despite those setbacks on the way to being an NFL football player. That's where we're going to relate. The failure. That's what nobody feels comfortable talking about. Everyone wants to show you their highlight reel. Highlight reels are great, but let's face it, they also don't reflect reality. If you want to truly be the best version of yourself, you can't just own your highlight reel. You must be prepared to own everything. Your good plays, your bad plays, your wins, and your losses. If you can do that, you have a chance at a truly great life. So let's huddle up and see how great you really can be. The Kickoff. My flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. Psalm 73, verse 26. I'm not going to lie, most people really don't care about special teams. None of the superstar players are on the field. Fans don't pay much attention to what are considered routine plays to move the game along, and little more. You might think these plays are a waste of time and interrupt the flow of the game, but for the men in the arena, the guys doing the dirty work that often goes unnoticed, this is where we make our living. We're a bunch of guys giving max effort at max velocity to chase one more payday, or what the guys in the locker room refer to as a game check. Life as a special teams player is pretty simple in one way. If we don't play, we don't get paid. Remember the 2006 movie Invincible with Mark Wahlberg playing Philadelphia Eagles player Vince Papale? Vince was pure grit and determination, finding any way to impact the game and make up for his lack of God-given ability. Punts and kicks have anywhere from 10 to 15 Vince Papales on the field during games these days. Every Vince has a burning reason to go full tilt every time he steps on the field. Teams have these plays broken down to a science, as 22 guys start in a box, expand to 20-mile-per-hour speeds over 50 yards, and condense into massive collisions in a matter of seconds. That science makes special teams plays routine almost every time. Unfortunately, there was nothing routine for me about a punt play on November 14, 2021, late in the first quarter of the Las Vegas Raiders game against the Kansas City Chiefs. This was our national coming-out party. We were 5-3, and we wanted to make a statement to a national audience that we were legit contenders. A chance to beat the big brother Chiefs that had our number since I'd been in the league. I was dialed in. I was the Raiders' team captain and our team's National Football League Players Association rep in only my third year on the team. I had also been named a Walter Payton Man of the Year nominee and was a Pro Bowl alternate in 2019. I don't say this to pat myself on the back. I want you to understand how I play on special teams, typically full tilt and all out. I always step onto the field with a sense of urgency and a need to relentlessly carve out a role for myself after going undrafted in 2019. This was the week to let everyone know I was in the top tier of fullbacks in the world. My job wasn't always to rack up big stats. My job was to help our team find a way to just win, baby, any way that I could. It was perfect for my brand of football, and I took pride in throwing key blocks, catching passes, barreling through people on handoffs, pumping up my teammates, and generating as much positive energy as I could on every play, whether I was on the field or not. I was also honored to be our special teams captain, which is why I was on the field for that fourth down punt. On that play, our Pro Bowl punter, my guy AJ Cole, sailed a punt to the Chiefs' Mike Hughes, who ran it back but fumbled on the play, giving us possession. But I never saw the fumble. I was lined up at right guard, and my job was to get downfield as quickly as possible to cover the punt. I got hemmed in at the line of scrimmage and was being blocked to the right. So I planted my foot to turn left and accelerate to start my pursuit. That's when it happened. My leg gave out. My knee twisted. I heard a pop. I knew immediately something was wrong. Really wrong. In a split second, I was on the ground grabbing my knee. My anterior cruciate ligament was shredded, completely torn. And my season ended on that play. I hobbled off the field and into the blue injury tent. After a quick look, the staff knew immediately what had happened. Television footage from that day shows me being driven off the field in a cart, tears filling my eyes. You might assume those tears were because of the physical pain an injury like that can produce. But that's not why I was crying. Truth be told, when you tear an ACL, there is very little physical pain. If you were watching that day, the pain you saw was emotional pain. I couldn't keep it in. I had worked so hard, accomplished so many of my goals, and was living a dream I had spent my entire life working toward. I went from the highest of highs to a future filled with uncertainty in the blink of an eye. When you're a pro athlete, or an athlete at any level, you accept injuries as part of the risk. I don't avoid contact or physicality. I pride myself on playing through injuries, bumps, and bruises. It's just a part of the game. You do what you can to guard against injuries, a meticulous routine that maximizes your chances at longevity in the league. Still, there aren't any guarantees. Like so many other players before me, I found this out in the cruelest of ways. As I write this, my injury took place a little over 12 weeks ago, and I'm deep into a rehab process that will go on for several more months. Most ACL tears can't be sutured back together. To restore knee stability and repair the ACL, the ligament must be reconstructed. That's why the recovery process takes so long. I've faced a lot of adversity in my life, but never anything quite like this. I'm trying to use the time as productively as possible, but I'm not gonna lie, some days, and many nights, are incredibly difficult, filled with anxiety, doubt, and fear. If there's a silver lining, it's that this time has also given me a break to reflect on the adversities I've faced in my life. I've been able to put things into perspective, take a step back, and think about what's important to me, and reconnect with my faith at an even deeper level. I'm no stranger to adversity. I've overcome a lot in my life already. Using those experiences means I'm more prepared with what I need to do to overcome this torn ACL, which is arguably the biggest challenge I've ever faced. Because I have always believed in giving back, I'm also using this time to share with you what I've learned about adversity along the way. Through my experiences, I want to help you to better overcome the various kinds of adversity you face in your life. If I can unlock some of those answers for you, then the downtime I've spent with my injury, no matter what comes next, will be time well spent. What are the Seven Crucibles? A crucible is a situation of severe trial, or in which different elements interact, leading to the creation of something new. It's not just battling with something physically or mentally. A crucible is that problem that takes everything out of you and tests you down to your core. In other words, crucibles are the product of overcoming extreme adversity to produce change that results in something new and often better. The seven crucibles I want to tell you about: purpose, competition, grind set, support, leadership, discipline, and perspective have profoundly impacted my life. Each of them has been a form of severe trial, challenging me mentally, physically, spiritually, and emotionally. The high temperatures of these crucibles have transformed me, and although the trials have been tough, these crucibles have made me a better person. You might ask, are there more than seven crucibles? Of course there are. I'm positive you have a different amount or types of crucibles that have changed you. For me, as a Christian with a profound commitment and connection to my faith, the number seven in the Bible represents completeness or perfection. Understand that in no way am I complete or perfect, but to this point in my life, I have been put through these seven crucibles. Together, they have transformed me into the person I am today. In that way, I am the best possible, complete, and perfect version of who I am right now. As I continue to grow, learn, and remain humbled by the world around me, there is little doubt that I'll add more crucibles. That's the whole point. That's life. Each of us conquers our crucibles, resulting in a deeper understanding of who we are, allowing us to use all those life lessons for our next inevitable test. For now, I want to focus on these seven. I want to tell you how they have affected me and share insights you can use in your own life. In this way, I hope to help you become a more complete and perfect version of who you are and were meant to be. Overcoming adversity is also easier when it's a shared journey. Although our battles aren't the same, the notion of overcoming them is. As I tell you about my struggles, I know you'll see commonalities with your own struggles and take strength and comfort in knowing you and I and everyone else are connected by adversity. The bottom line is this: do I have all the answers you're looking for? Not a chance. Can I help you by sharing my struggles so that you can apply them in your own way? 100% yes. As a pro football player, I've been blessed in many ways. You see one thing when my teammates and I step on the field every week. What you don't see is the daily sacrifice to get there. That's the job. That's where we relate the most. That's where the adversity happens. It's where the doubt, anxiety, and stress try to shake us the most. I want you to understand that you've been blessed too. There's much more that binds us together than what separates us, no matter who you are or what you do in life. Deciding to embrace change. Each of the seven crucibles teaches you something about the world and something about yourself. While they are distinct, they also share one thing in common. The seven crucibles are all about embracing change. Change usually isn't pleasant. Many times it's born out of necessity, whether rehabbing from an ACL injury, getting over the loss of a loved one, forging new business relationships, or graduating from high school or college. You can't live a great life and avoid change. The smartest thing you can do is embrace change. Change teaches you a lot about yourself. Change makes you tough and resilient. Change is about learning how to overcome your doubts, anxieties, and fears about your future, and letting go of the past. It's about figuring out what you're made of and what you really want in life, and what sacrifices you're willing to make if you really want to succeed. Change helps you assess your current state in life and adjust it to get through the crucibles you've been blessed or challenged to endure. As you'll discover, I am supremely blessed with the life that God has bestowed upon me. Through my own crucibles, I've learned a lot about who I am and why God has brought change into my life. Before I dig into the seven crucibles, I want to leave you with a story about what happened as I was sitting in the locker room after my injury took place. Our quarterback, Derek Carr, came up to me, hugged me, and he said, "Deal with this however you need to deal with it for tonight. But when you wake up tomorrow, you gotta decide how you're gonna come back from this. You're gonna have to."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.